You see that? No color information at all. Completely blown out. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Next to making sure that your subject is in focus, getting correct exposure is one of the most important responsibilities that you have as a photographer. And one part of it that I would like to address today are 5 exposure warning tools that are built right into your Fujifilm camera to warn you about your exposure before you take your shot. Those are the LCD screen, the exposure indicator, the histogram, the live view highlight alert, and the zebra. Well, not that kind of zebra, the other kind of zebra. Got that? Good. Now, let's get to the tools. First up is the LCD screen. This is the most often used tool that beginning photographers go to. An LCD screen is just a guideline. It kind of gives you an overall impression of what the scene will look like, but on a screen this small, with too many variables of brightness and ambient light, etc., it should not be the only tool that you use to properly judge your exposure. Okay, have a look at this example here. Here's a situation where, let's say you're using the LCD screen only, and you realize you want to make, you know, the word on the hammer appear brighter. So you turn up your exposure, and now, hey, it looks great. You can read the word Stanley perfectly. By the way, they make great hammers. Okay, so if you bring the photo into Lightroom, have a look at this. You can clearly see that right at this part of the image that you were looking at through the LCD screen, it came out fine. You can see it great. No problem there. But look at the other areas of the image that you may not have noticed when you were looking through the back of the LCD screen. It's completely blown out. These highlights are ruined. You're never gonna get them back. There's no color information. You may as well toss them out the window. Have a look at this. If I go and I try and bring down those highlights to recover, I've got this thing cranked all the way down. And even if I try and bring my exposure down, look at that. Nothing. There's nothing there. Garbage in, garbage out. That's the problem with relying on the LCD screen. And of course, if you're shooting JPEG only, it's far worse, as I'm showing you here. But let's switch over to the RAW version of this same image. Have a look at this. I'm looking at RAW, and you know how they say with RAW, oh, you can fix it in post. Well, no, you can't. Not all the time if you've blown out your highlights. I'm gonna bring down the highlights all the way, and it's better than the JPEG. It's better, but look. Look at that. It still sucks. So do not rely on the LCD screen for your exposure tool. Use another tool as well. Think of the LCD screen as sort of a starting point and what you would use, obviously, to judge your framing and compose the shot. Next up is number 2, the exposure indicator. This is the little guide located on the left side of your screen that shows the number of stops that the camera thinks is either over, under, or properly exposed. You know, that's just like the camera's opinion, man. And if you have spot metering on, then it may miss things that are outside of where the camera is metering the scene. So I would not use this one a whole lot, particularly in situations with high dynamic range and when you have spot metering turned on. Number 3 is the histogram. Now, overall, the histogram is the single best tool available on the Fujifilm camera to help you accurately nail exposure. And it will especially prevent you from blowing out those highlights. This is because oftentimes there are areas in your image that you can't see that are blowing out highlights if you're just using your LCD screen to judge exposure. A histogram is a graph that shows the amount of tones that are all contained in your image that range from pure black on the left to pure white on the right, and everything in between, like all the various shades of gray and so forth. This little graph sits right here and changes live as you aim and move your camera around and expose the scene. Now, as you crank up exposure and let more light into your image, the histogram moves all the pixels over toward the right. Now, at some point, you may have an area of your photo that's so bright, It literally shows all of the pixels crunched up to the right side in the pure white area. And having large areas of pure white in your images will make me mad, bad, and sad, because when your histogram builds that skyscraper way up right there, you end up with clipped or blown highlights. And that means it's so damn bright that the color information has been stripped away. It's like this. Bright light blowing everything out. You see that? No color information at all. Completely blown out. And remember, the opposite direction is true. If you have that skyscraper building rising up to the sky all the way on the left, then you will be stuck with black areas of your image, and that will suck also. Like any tool, the use of a histogram will depend entirely on your subject, scene, and the story that you're trying to tell in your photo. But as a general rule of thumb, and especially if you're new to reading a histogram, you want to keep those lines from going up on either side and the pixels in your histogram spread evenly across the tonality of your image, the tonal range of your image. The X-T3 and X-T4 also offer an RGB histogram. An RGB histogram is like a regular histogram, but on steroids. This histogram displays four different histograms at the same time: the standard histogram and a separate histogram for red, green, and blue. This is going to be a Fast Friday video topic coming soon that goes over the RGB histogram, so I'm going to save that for that. But for now, here's what I want you to do. Go into your screen setup, scroll down to the second page, display custom setting. In here, tick off histogram. Next, we're going to assign a touch function to it. And what you do there is you press and hold the DISP back button down, boom, until it's like that. Scroll down till you get to your touch screen. And what I like to do on the touch screen going up, like whoosh, I like to assign that to histogram. And if you assign it to histogram on the touch screen, it will then give you the RGB histogram. So once I do that, now watch what happens. I take my finger, I go, check it out, how about that? And you turn it off, just like that. And so what's great about that is not only are you getting the histogram on steroids, RGB version of it, but you are also getting it larger, so it's easier to see if you have crappy eyes like I do. And then the other one, obviously, that you set is the regular histogram that appears at all times, the little one right on the screen right there. But your histogram is not a perfect tool either. The histogram shows you the exposure as the camera interprets it after, and the word is after, it applies whatever film simulation and JPEG settings you've already set in the camera. This means that you are seeing the effects of in-camera processing in your histogram already, including the white balance, the film sims, etc. And the only way to prevent that is to turn on natural live view. But I'm getting down another rabbit hole here. I will make a Fast Friday video on this very subject, including my she method. There's more to unpack here with this, so stay tuned for that video. But in the meantime, definitely enable both your regular histogram and your RGB histogram as well. Number four is the Live View Highlight Alert. Live View Highlight Alert is a great tool to quickly see clipped highlights in the scene. To enable it, you go into your menu, into Screen Setup, scroll down to DISP custom setting, and tick the box that says Live View Highlight Alert. Once you do that, as you rotate the camera and get it to a situation where something's going to be clipped, like my white shirt, check it out. That's too much white. Color loss, color loss. That's what the Live View Highlight Alert does. So you turn down the exposure, see this? See that? Till it's gone. Whew. The problem with this tool is that you don't want to have it on all the time. It kind of gets annoying because, you know, it's there all the time. And still, it can be a very handy tool to use in certain situations. And finally, we come to Zebra. The video capabilities on your Fujifilm camera include one additional exposure tool that's not available for still shooting, and that's called the Zebra function. The Zebra function allows you to pick a brightness threshold. And then the camera will show you zebra stripes if you match or go above that value. To turn on the zebra for video mode, scroll down until you see the word zebra. There it is, and simply turn it on. Now, you have a choice here. You can make them zebra to the right or zebra to the left, right? Who cares? Whichever one, pick one, choose it. The next one is called zebra level, and the camera will allow you to set the zebra level from either 50% all the way up to 100%. These numbers are meant to match waveform IRE values, which is how video signal is measured. Pure black is 0 IRE, and pure white is 100 IRE. I usually set my zebra between 60% and 70%, and I've had fairly good results with those settings. So give that a shot if you haven't set it up yet. Unlike the Live View Highlight Alert tool, the zebra function can be assigned to a custom button or a menu item, which is great for video shooters. Whew. That was exhausting. All right, while these five tools are immensely helpful, there is one major point, or kind of gotcha, that I want to point out to you right now. Yes, these are tools. Yes, they are helpful. And yes, by using them correctly, you are going to get better photographs and video with your Fujifilm camera. However, there is the most important rule of all is this. Got that? Good. I hope you found this video helpful. And if you did, please consider giving it the like and subscribe. And I will see you again in a video real soon. Take care. I need to customize the way I can get this line out. This is the second, third, fourth, fifth take. All right, let's try this again. Unlike the live alert view. I can't take this anymore. Welcome. Try this again. Unlike the live view.